It's time for a date with Danu right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. We've got ourselves to the Movenpick Hotel, and this is the mansion. When I sit on this grand chair, it's all about having a fun conversation with someone who you already know. But this show is all about coming to know a little bit more. The first guest on my show, she is just so fit. She sings, she looks phenomenal, and she has a lot to say. A person full of life, I'm happy to have Tanuja with me on a date with Danu. Is the date with Danu, and she looks phenomenal. Hello.
Hello.
And thanks for joining us on the show. And I just heard that you recovered from dengue.
Oh gosh, I did.
Yeah,
I'm still recovering.
I know, but you recovered well.
Thank you. Thank
you. Fabulous.
Thank you so much.
So how was that? It's just so scary when you do think of it.
Yeah, you know what? I was always scared that I was going to get it because I was somebody who always got bitten. And I think they're attracted to certain blood types.
You know that they never bite me.
Yeah, so like certain blood types never get bitten and others get bitten all the time. And I part of my routine every day is shower, body lotion, mosquito repellent. It's just, you know, it's been like that since I moved here. But I still managed to get bit, and
it was
a serious one. I was very ill. I was in hospital for about a week in intensive care, and it was and they nearly lost me. But God willing, God pulled me through. So
happy to have you here.
I'm happy to be alive and happy to be here. Thank you.
All right, so let's break it down. So you were not living most of your life here.
I grew up in London. I spent a little bit of time here when I was a kid. Moved to London when I was quite young. Spent most of my childhood and adult life there.
Mm.
And then decided to move back here about next year.
Somewhere during Colombo Fashion Week is when I started seeing you around.
Mm-hmm.
But what made you make the shift here? And mostly your sister is still in London then?
No, she's actually just moved here as well.
Really?
Yeah,
this
she's
is
just
breaking
moved.
News.
Yeah, it is. She's just actually moved here a few weeks ago, so
okay. It's
really nice to have her here.
What is it? Why is it that's
you know what?
Her come
I don't
back?
Know. My mum was spending a lot of time here, and I was just at a point in my life where I was just not really enjoying London or New York. I was kind of shifting between the two places, and I wasn't really happy in either. And I didn't have any intention of moving here. I came here on a holiday to spend some time with my mom. And while I was here, things just, I don't know, they just started happening very quickly. Opportunities started to come my way. And I'm a person who really believes in energy and feel. And I felt like something kind of clicked when I came here, bizarrely, because people tell me I'm nuts. Like, why the hell do you want to live here when you were living in London, New York?
Yeah.
But I don't know, like something energetically clicked for me here, and I felt like things were moving in the right direction.
Even though those mosquitoes were biting.
Yes.
Yeah.
Even though those mosquitoes were biting. I mean, I just decided to go with that flow, and I've been here ever since.
So now we know Tanuja sings, she looks great, she's into fitness. These are things that we know about you here in Colombo or in Sri Lanka.
Mm-hmm.
What is it that was keeping you sort of buzzing while you were in New York and in London?
I don't know. I mean, I've always been doing what I do. I've been doing this now for, I would say, the last 10 years or so, with the fitness thing at least, music even longer.
Right.
So I was doing those things there as well. I don't know. I think there was just, coming to Sri Lanka, there's just so much more opportunities as well, you know. And for me, it kind of gave me an opportunity here to give fitness and sport and, you know, that kind of thing, a bit more of a platform. Mm. When I came here, it was really in its infancy and people were just starting to get into it. Fitness, but I think in the last 5 years, there's been a massive shift.
Huge
shift. And I think, you know, down to Instagram and things like that, you know, where fitness is such a, you know, a trend.
True.
That everyone is kind of into it. And it's great. You know, I'm like really happy that fitness is now such a big thing, because I'd rather people are addicted to fitness than, you
anything
know, other
else.
Stuff that they're not, you
know,
that's not good
for them.
I know, because
we come from such an island mentality and
yeah.
we believe in taking things easy and we love
Absolutely.
Just having some food to eat and just, you know,
yes,
after a good heavy out. Lunch, we want to sleep.
Yes, yes, yes. Listen, I'm not going to lie. I really got into the afternoon
oh
nap
my
thing.
God,
it's like
great,
saves my life.
It's heavenly,
it
right?
It really does
I
save
know,
my life.
I know, the minute you get used to it, you're like, I'm so
now when I don't have my little afternoon nap, I feel like a complete,
really?
Like, yeah.
I don't have that luxury there.
I know. I thankfully do, because yeah. I dictate my own schedule.
And also,
so I also
the
try
problem
to, always
is that,
try to schedule something in.
Yeah, and also you wake up at crack of dawn.
I wake up really early. So
yeah.
for me, by the time I get to lunchtime, when you teach, it really takes a lot of energy out of you. So when I get to about 12, I need to chill for a couple of hours before I start work again.
And I've always had a good laugh with her, and that's a great thing. But there is a silent partner in her life. Well, he's quite silent because he's restricted to 7 words for his whole day. He puts a checklist saying, I will speak 7 words for today, and these will be my 7.
He also doesn't get a lot of chance being with me. I take up all the words.
So today on the show, we just needed some gluteus. So we have got him on the show just so that he could sit pretty.
Sorry.
Just to sit pretty for me on the show, and occasionally we'll be holding hands. On the other side of the show, we'll be joined by her husband, Gluteus, right here on A Date with Danu on High TV.
So good, I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. So good, so good. I got to you.
Welcome back to the show. This is A Date with Danu right here on High TV. Happy to have Tanuja and joined by Hasitha, aka Gluteus. And that's a name that we found for him today.
You found.
Yeah. But can you blame me? He wouldn't sit because he just didn't want to crush his beautiful bottom. So this boy is very limited with words, so I'm going to be kind to you.
Okay. Good.
Yeah? Okay. Use one word. We have yes. 6 more to go.
6 more. Don't use them all at once.
All right. So tell me about you. You're someone who's very strict when it comes to your fitness routines. I've seen you because when you train, there's literally no smile on you. You're literally like, just do it. And because I saw one video going up from one of your clients saying, I can't thank my trainer enough, and it was you. So tell me about what made you get into fitness, and is that the link sort of that attracted the two of you all?
Well, when I first got into fitness, it was because of a friend of mine. Like, he basically wanted to like work out, so he wanted a partner. And I was very reluctant. But he was like, no, come, let's try it out.
And this was how young were you?
No, I'm going to interject, because he got into fitness because somebody told him that he was really weak and he couldn't even do a bicep curl with like a 2 kg or something. So to prove them wrong, he really went all out.
But you have been in it for a long time though. We're talking about some time ago.
Yeah, yeah. This was when I was about 16, I would say.
Okay.
Yeah, about 8-9 years ago.
Okay. So you were not into like sports?
Well, when I was in school, I was like athletics, swimming, cricket, all of it.
Right.
Basketball. I sucked at basketball.
but you're so tall, you could just throw it from wherever you are. Just like, or is it just you can't
I wasn't very good at it.
you just can't find that little spot to throw the ball into.
Sorry. You know, I knew this was going to happen. Yeah. You're just like, I'm used to it.
Now, we need to speak about a few things that are a bit sticky.
Oh, God.
Which makes this show more interesting.
All right.
But I would speak to you all on it, and it's up to you to sort of work around it. All right.
Okay.
So let's get into the sticky city. So this is a sticky situ. Right, it's not so sticky. I think Colombo knows about it and Sri Lanka knows about it. You guys obviously have an age gap.
Yeah.
But was this a problem when you guys have to like sort of, you know, tie the knot or take it onto a paper and say, we are married?
I mean, yes and no.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, listen, all I'm going to say about it is this. Yes, there is an age gap. And I'm sure that everybody talks about it and all the rest of it. But I think, you know, if you love somebody, that really shouldn't matter.
I know.
And second of all, if I was a man, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Definitely.
So there we go.
Because you're like, because 100%.
Men do this all the time. It's not an issue.
Yeah.
But if you're a woman who's older, then it's a problem.
It
and
is.
I don't
Look
think
at Priyanka Chopra, poor girl. She's just being chopped up.
I mean, at the end of the day, it shouldn't matter if men marry women that are younger than them all the time. In fact, it is expected that a man that is successful and wealthy has a younger woman on his arm, then nowadays women are just as successful and just as fabulous and fly, so why the hell can't we?
Definitely. I'm with you on that. But tell me about how was it when you had to break the story to your parents or like to your home front? Because, you know, we do come from Sri Lanka and we do fall into that category of, oh my God, really? Like, is she older? Like, how are we going to do this? And how are we going to tell the family? You know, there's so much of questions that follow.
Yeah.
But how was it? Because, you know, I always believe that love has to win.
It does.
That's my policy in anything.
100%.
Like, even if it's a dog that you love, means if you passionately love it, you will adopt it somehow.
Of course.
That's how it is, like this.
Are you saying I'm a dog that they adopted?
No. But tell me about how was it for you to when to break this ice and sort of take it there?
Yeah, well, like, when I told my parents, obviously, like, they weren't mad or anything like that, but they were a bit icky about
it. Of course,
it. Yeah.
Like, any family would be, especially Sri Lankans, it was tough to take.
But your mum loves him more.
My mum loves him, and it's never... My family are, you know, I don't know, I guess they're a bit more... Open-minded because they've, you know, we grew up in a different culture and a different, you know, city, but... Hustler's family, you know, has been incredibly supportive and amazing, and I am really close to them, and I'm really lucky because, you know, I don't think there are a lot of people that would have been so accepting, and, you know, they have been, so...
You know, what's really remarkable is that today is Hasitha's mum's birthday, and he, I don't know where he was thinking, but he has just completely forgotten.
Yeah, the wife was living a cuckoo land as usual.
And the wife is just grilling, why didn't I
speak to
her this morning?
No, because I was talking to her this morning, and we were messaging each other, and then I find out now later it was her birthday, and I didn't even wish it. Like, I was like, oh my God, I must just look. Because honestly, when I was sick, Hasta's mom was amazing.
Aww.
She was like in the hospital with me every day. She was coming home every day. She really looked after me.
Aww.
I felt so bad that he didn't tell me because I just looked like
a really tacky daughter-in-law. I'm going to be spanking him after the show.
I'm sure. Yeah. Go ahead.
But men find it very fascinating when it's an older woman. How are your friends about it? They're like, machang. My look at Nujavilu. Do you have this conversation? Do they like say, oh my God, like, yeah, you speak 7 words for a day. How did you manage to get this sorted?
Well, yeah, obviously, like, they think that she's hot and stuff.
Yeah.
But then they were wondering, like, why I got married so young.
Yeah.
That was their biggest issue.
Yeah.
But I was like, well, when you feel it, you know it, that you need to get it done, you know?
Yeah.
And I think, like, and I know that I made the right decision.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, like, we've got, like, the rest of our lives now, like, to live and, like, figure out how we're going to build our family, how we're going to move forward with our business together, all of that. So,
yeah.
It works out well.
You know. I mean, you know fairly early on. And
yeah.
I don't know, for me, it just felt right.
Yeah.
You know, everything about it on paper was like, no. But...
I've always been the person that goes with feeling.
Like,
yeah.
Everything can be, if everything on paper says no, but you feel like it's right,
yeah.
Then it's right.
I'm totally cool to, you know, marry Harshit at any time.
If anything goes wrong, I'll let you know.
I should have been your maid of honor.
You would have been pulling my dress off.
Trip, woman, trip.
Me out there on the aisle.
Trip, woman, trip. But I'm genuinely happy that you came out of dengue, though.
Oh, good. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I feel that.
I'm really so happy that we can laugh about it now. Let's get into a break. When we do come back, we're going to be speaking a little bit more about what their lives are made of and what's going to be that's going to keep them together forever. More on the show, of course, when we do join you right here on The Date with Dana. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. Welcome back to the show. All right, so something that I need to ask is that now Tanuja is a type who can really speak a lot.
Yeah. She can.
Yeah.
Yeah. No problems in that department.
Yes. How do you handle that?
Well, I'm the silent one. Yeah. So it's better that she talks because she has better, I would
communication skills
than me. Yeah.
Who gets in the last word? That's the most important thing.
She does.
Obviously, no man.
There you go.
We just had this discussion about are you a Libra as well?
No, I'm an Aries.
Okay.
Libra rising.
Right. But I must say, I always have in the last word. Like, we'll have this blow. I'm sure my sister is always right when we have an argument. Yeah. But I just feel I'm right.
Yeah.
And when I sit back and think I am wrong.
So,
but
it's and you just, have to go, so there.
And of course, you need to have the nose up in the air walk off because it helps you. It just keeps you going.
We don't have many of those kind of arguments, I have to say. We don't fight that much.
But yeah, hello, 7 words. You're done with it by
the
time.
Yeah, exactly. I'm just talking to myself.
But you're done with it by 8 o'clock in the morning and you're like, okay, now it's just going to be monologue for the rest of the day. Yeah.
Mine.
Yeah. Poor soul, man. I know how to do. All right. So now it's time that we get into something called WTFB.
Okay.
It's always nice to have the last word in. So, let's analyze. Have you ever thought of yourself as a queen?
Have I ever thought of myself as a queen?
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Sure? So that explains this.
Oh my gosh, I was so drunk in that picture. I'm not even going to lie, I was wasted.
So, when was this?
I know, I was actually, I don't know what I was doing. That was a candid. I wasn't actually posing thinking I was a queen. That was
but I must say, you look really pretty
thank
here,
thank you.
But
that was
where
a friend's,
was this?
That was in London.
You I
was,
can have a, this.
Oh,
it's
thank you. Look, yeah. You printed off all these lovely pics of me.
I'm just for you to frame up.
I was, I wasn't posing for this. It was a candid shot.
But, you know, I always feel really bad for men who are soft-spoken. Something about, I feel that, you know, there's so much that they have to say. But you have always ruled men, like, just whip them hard, and you have just been very, like Lady Gaga or like Madonna.
Oh, dear.
What's that?
Oh, dear.
What's this? What's this poor man doing?
Oh, my God. We were, we were out having a night out. This was in England as well.
Yeah.
And we found this guy tied to a pole. It was a stag night. He was tied to a pole with like
so
his
who
hands.
Is this man?
Just some random dude. We have no idea who he was. So I was like, right, let's go and I'll stand on him. And let's take a picture of me putting my heel into his butt. So that's what was happening there.
That's for you.
Thanks.
Oh, it takes you back in time, right?
Look, his butt is out.
But you know, before we get into something with you, I really have to speak about something. I don't know what you did. You have groomed this man really well.
Oh, hell yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Come on.
We did a makeover on Hussy Boy. We had
Hussy
to polish,
Boy.
We had to polish this rough diamond.
I know. I'm telling you, you are a diamond. That I agree. But, man, you were just a rock before this. Just like in the bay or somewhere. Like a galak. Bangwaniha malak. But I must say, explain this
please.
Look to me.
Oh my God, that is one of his better looks. I've seen even worse.
Okay, so
what is going on there? What is the tip all about?
Big match pick.
What is that little thing?
No, but Hasid, the big match pick, fine. You're wearing a match t-shirt.
What's
going
that?
On there? All of your hair like a bouffant, then comes up into like a little thin line? Yeah.
What is this tip? Explain, give it to me.
It's a bouffant tip.
I don't know what
look
that
at
is.
This.
Yeah, like you're a, like a marker
like
pin.
Like a mushroom with a mohawk.
He's like, actually, he's like a marker pen, you know, like a highlighter, like a thick one.
My sister has shown me some pictures where I've just gone, Jesus Christ, I can't believe I married you.
But no, I hope not all tips are thin.
Thankfully, no.
Oh, there you go. We got to know everything about you. From your calf, the lower body is completely covered.
Yeah.
All right. So this is before or after fitness?
This was
just when he was getting into it, right? Yeah, just starting out.
Third year, I would say.
Why don't you put up anything now?
Yeah, he's become very shy in the last few years.
What have you done to him?
Nothing. I don't tell him to be shy at all.
I want the more thing of these like, up and running on your Facebook.
The thing is, like, I'm not into like bodybuilding at the moment. So.
I don't care. Can you just send me a few?
That I just could
feel,
be a rape.
Yeah, I just feel this is very pedo for me to like take a print out of it.
Yeah, it's a little worrying to be honest. Don't know, I have to say.
But yeah, I like what we are working with here. All right, so that's
it's a good start.
It's a good start. All right, last but not least, we just definitely shocked a few people, but I must say God has really blessed you, Tanuja. God has.
I didn't take that picture.
But you are shaped so fine. And
thanks.
I like the fact that they have given emphasis to the right, most important parts of your body. Whose finger is it?
God knows, actually. I don't
know. It's a European finger.
It's a long time ago. Yeah. God knows. At some party, and then I was wearing this dress, and they were like, oh, those look good. Let me take a picture.
Just that.
That's like, basically what happened.
They didn't even want your face.
My nickname was Melons.
Aww.
Yeah. Sweet.
And now you get to have it all.
Yeah.
So actually, your Facebooks are actually quite all right.
Really?
Y'all don't have much.
Gosh, I have people get old pictures of me on Facebook and like blackmail me about them. I'm like, I'm not ashamed of this stuff.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have put it up otherwise. Why would you try to like, you know, shame me with my old Facebook
posts? I'm going
to
get somebody to host this show to interview me.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to get
definitely.
You to do it.
Me?
Yeah. You might just kill me.
You know what? After all the things you've done to me today, bring it on.
All right. So before we wrap things up on the show, I personally find that you two guys really make a great couple.
Thanks.
And it's very rare that you find someone interested in the similar things to actually wake up in the morning and do something together and love it.
Yeah. It is rare.
You have not tried to make him part of your singing band.
Well, he sucks. He sounds like a dying cat. So, I mean, if he could sing, trust me, he'd be there in the background with a tambourine, do some backing vocals. But
you know, we all need to upgrade our standards of performance. You know, just something nice for him to wear.
But yeah, just put him in a corner, like being my like backup go-go dancer.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But
just,
you'd like that. You'd
of course. For some corporate events, you could propose... Me plus Hasita. You can pick his outfit.
Yeah, go boys.
Sorry. Well, thank you guys for coming. It has been an honor.
Thank you.
And we'll have more of this.
Yes.
Yeah.
But so, next time I'm going to be the one who's going to be shaming you.
Yeah. All right. We need to wrap things up on the show. We'll see you with another wonderful episode on A Date with Danu. Till then, you have yourself a great day. It's a wrap right here on ITV. Say that.